Hey everyone, graphics cards are really expensive. You know, AMD's flagship one at the moment is often selling for more than like MSRP. So that sucks, but if you've seen a deal on a really good CPU on like AliExpress or a local retailer, you might be wondering if you can buy that, and that'll compensate for a slightly underpowered graphics card. Maybe you want to keep your existing, you know, GPU, but just upgrade the CPU. Will that work? Well, the short answer is probably not, because even if you've bought like an X3D CPU after reading that they're really good for gaming, if you couple that with a really underpowered GPU, then unfortunately, you know, you've just got an unbalanced system, because ultimately when you're gaming, it's the graphics card that is doing most of the work. Yeah, it's slightly different with like Flight Simulator and RPGs, where the CPU does help too, but ultimately you're still playing a graphical game, and as a result, the graphics card is the most important thing. So simply, you know, keeping an underpowered GPU and then upgrading your CPU unfortunately won't work, but especially for like 1440p and 4K gaming. But obviously, you could look at, if you want to keep your old GPU, you could look at simply dialing things down to like 1080p or even 720p and trying to game on that, because ultimately that's going to be a cheaper way of doing things than running out and spending like £1,000 or $1,000 on a new graphics card. I do get that. And actually, if you've got a fairly modern Nvidia graphics card, for example, you can often use DLSS4, and actually, you know, you could be gaming at 1080p internally, it could be rendering it at like 720p or even 480p, and actually it can lead to some really, really good results. So that is one option, you know, is just play around with graphical settings and things like DLSS or XeSS from Intel or FSR from AMD, which are upscaling technologies, and they can often allow a slightly underpowered graphics card to actually perform slightly better. I'd personally go that route before buying like a new CPU. Like, there's no point of having like a really, really old graphics card and then buying like a 9800X3D, because ultimately it's still the graphics card that's going to be holding you back in that situation when gaming. Hopefully that makes sense. If you've got any further questions, please let me know down in the comments. If you enjoyed this video, please click the thumbs up button and please subscribe to see more short videos like this. Thanks for watching.